The Witcher Season 2 Explained. In this series of videos, we are going to discuss everything that actually happened in each episode, even if it has not yet been explained in the show adaptation. So we are going to provide extra color into things such as Ciri's Elder Blood, Lara Dorne, Falca, Unicorns, Amirvar Emrys, The Wild Hunt, and Ryan's Secret Employer. So to be clear, this Explained series is not just a recap. These videos will have book spoilers for stuff that the show has not yet fully explained. Let's start with a high-level recap of the episode using the map, then we'll dive into the details. Geralt reunited with Ciri in Riverdale. They then began to head north to Kaer Morhen. In order to get across the Yoruga River, they crossed its Sodden Hill, which is where the battle had taken place. Therefore, they ran into Tisaya, who told Geralt that Yennefer was dead. Geralt and Ciri then continued north, but Geralt sensed danger, so they stopped off in Redania at Nevelyn's Manor. Afterwards, they kept riding north to Kaer Morhen. Meanwhile, Fringilla captured Yennefer and she began to take Yennefer to Syntra as a hostage. However, on their way, the captor became the captive when Francesca and Filivandro's elves captured Fringilla and Yennefer at the end of the episode. The third subplot involved the Northern Mages. In the aftermath of battle, Tisaya was upset that she could not find Yennefer. Tisaya briefly spoke to Geralt, then she went back to Aretusa, where they healed Triss and began to interrogate Cahir with magic. That is the high-level recap. Now, let's get into the details, starting with Geralt and Ciri. Ciri had had a vision of meeting Tisaya on the battlefield. On top of that, Geralt had seen Ciri's mother, Pavetta, do magic. So Geralt began to realize that Ciri was special, but it took time for him to realize how special she was. While traveling north, Ciri told Geralt that she had had nightmares about Cahir and the fall of Syntra, but she lied to Geralt. She said that she had escaped by getting lucky. So at this point, Geralt did not know that Ciri had escaped Cahir using magical powers. Ciri asked Geralt about the Law of Surprise, and Geralt told her that he had saved her father's life from her grandmother. Geralt told Ciri that her father didn't know what he was giving up. That line had a hidden meaning for hardcore fans. When Emir offered Geralt the Law of Surprise, he did not yet realize that his daughter would be the Child of Destiny. So at the time, he did not know what he was giving up. That's not what Geralt meant by the line, but that's the hidden meaning. It was not until after Ciri was born that a specific mage met up with Emir and told him who Ciri was, a child of prophecy. We will get back to this in a few minutes. So Geralt and Ciri were traveling north to Kaer Morhen. A roach could sense danger. Geralt then tasted the flesh of a dead animal, and presumably that allowed Geralt to see the dead animal's memories. Therefore, Geralt knew that it was attacked by a monster, so they rode hard for the nearest town. When they got to the town, there were no guards and no barking dogs, which meant something bad had happened there. So Geralt decided to pull an audible and go to his friend Nivellin's manor instead. Nivellin was a friend of Geralt's, but Nivellin had changed since they last met. He had been cursed. At first, Nivellin told them that he had gotten high on godflesh mushrooms and trashed the temple of the lion-headed spider. After the damage was done, the priestess cursed him to live alone as a monster. But that's not what really happened. In truth, Nivellin raped the priestess. That is why she cursed him. When Nivellin first turned, he freaked out and killed all of his servants, something that he regrets until this day. Afterwards, Nivellin buried them in what he now refers to as the Statue Garden. So Nivellin could not control his powers, and as a result, he killed people whom he loved. That story resonated with Ciri, since she also has powers that she does not understand and cannot control. While Geralt looked around the manor for danger, Nivellin told Ciri a story called The Fall of the Elders. It was a story about an elven warrior who fell in love with a human mage, and they had a child. Nivellin doesn't know this, and he did not mention their names, but the elven warrior was Lara Dorne, Ciri's ancestor. Earlier in this episode, Nivellin had told Geralt that he saw the Wild Hunt riding their skeletal horses across the southern sky, and Ciri said that her grandfather saw them just before Syntra fell. So two references to the Wild Hunt in the first episode alone. In short version, the Wild Hunt is a group of Ein El elves who now live in a different sphere. The Wild Hunt is looking for Ciri since she is the descendant of Lara Dorne. More on this to come in future episodes. Now, let's take a look at Varina. Varina was a type of vampire called a Bruxa, a very dangerous type of vampire, a monster. Nivellin found her in the woods, injured and starving. And unlike humans, Verena wasn't scared of him. So he took her in and took care of her. When she healed, she chose to stay there with him. And to ease her cravings, he let her feed on him. But it wasn't enough. Verena killed the villagers. And Nivellyn turned his eyes from what she did. The things we do for love. At night, Verena approached Ciri and spoke to her telepathically. Ciri intrigued Verena, since Ciri was like her in a way. They both felt so alone. Then Verena left. Geralt got into a fight with her outside and stunned her, but Ciri liked Verena, so she ran over to cover her body. It was a trick. Verena then threatened to kill Ciri unless Geralt left, and she almost bit her, but Nivellyn stabbed her in the back. Then Geralt cut off her head. Since there is power in true love, Nivellyn unknowingly lifted his curse when he spilt her blood. So this scene had two major takeaways. First off, Nivellyn had to kill someone he loves. In a later episode, Geralt has to do the same thing to Eskull when the Leshy takes over his body. And even later, Vesemir tries to do the same with Ciri when Volothmir takes over her body. The second major takeaway from the scene is that there is power in true love. Since Yennefer came to look at Ciri like a daughter, when she sacrificed herself to Volothmir for the sake of Ciri, Yennefer's wound was healed. She got back her magic. Power in true love. Alright, now let's look at the Northern Mages. Triss almost died, but Taseya and Vilgefortz ran over and helped Artorias stabilize her. When doing so, Vilgefortz placed his hand over Taseya's hand, and once Triss was stabilized, Vilgefortz squeezed her hand. Does Vilgefortz actually care about Triss? Probably not. Does Vilgefortz actually care about Taseya? Sadly, probably not. But in short, Vilgefortz is a smooth operator. He is probably using love or the illusion of love to manipulate Taseya. After healing Triss, Taseya tried to interrogate Kahir with magic, but unfortunately for her, the only thing she found was evidence of a magical barrier in Kahir's head. So it begs the question, who put that barrier there? It may have been put there in advance of the battle by someone such as Fringilla, but there's also a chance that someone at Aretusa put up the magical barrier. And if so, the prime suspect is Vilgefortz. Vilgefortz may have put up the magical barrier inside Kahir's head so as to prevent Kahir from saying something that might give away the fact that Vilgefortz had been working with Emir Var Emrys for many years.